Namaste, I'm Ganesh Raut. Welcome to you all, the students, in this virtual class of English grammar, organized by Siddharth Shishodan Sunakulam. Before to start the topic, to continue the topic tense. I would like to show you the answers of the questions asked today. I hope you are sitting with your answers of the questions, and you will get your answers matched with the answers there. Ready? Okay. Let's see. The first question was, see, watch television now. And you have to use the correct tense here. Use the verb in the correct tense. So, the answer is, she is watching television now. Because we have tamar verb now there. So present continuous tense. Right? Okay, let's go to the next one. He come tomorrow. What's the tense we use over here? Simple future. Because tomorrow is there. The future time will be here. So, simple future tense. Next, third question. Hurry up! The taxi come. Let's see what the answer is. Hurry up! The taxi is coming. Present continuous tense. Do you know why? Because of this word of protection. Taxi is coming. Present continuous tense. Slow and steady win the race. Now you have to use the correct tense here. So what's the answer here? Slow and steady wins the race. Simple present tense. Why? Because it's a proverb. Yohano denotes social truth. So simple present tense. And slow and steady, this is a partial subject. Therefore, the partial subject defined exists, singular exists. Let's move on to next year, fifth number question. My brother be 25 next month. What's the tense? My brother will be. So you will do, sir. Will plus be. Why? Next is here. So to the time where we are. He denotes the action will happen. Will occur. And the last question was, we be here for 2 days. And the strength was the answer. Correct answer. We have been here. Have been. Present perfect tense. Why do you? Because of this. 4 plus period of time is with the be verb in the bracket. A short time taking verb. 4 plus period of time and be in the bracket. So, present perfect. It's V3 is been. Have been. Okay. Now, today, we shall be discussing on future continuous tense. Okay. Future continuous tense. As usual, we'll divide its study in three categories: concept, structure, and uses. Let's see first the concept. What is simple? So, what is future continuous tense? What future continuous tense is? How do you know it? Business. Let's see the timeline again here. This will be beneficial to you. This point is present point. Now, okay. Now, from here to the left, it denotes past time. And to the right, future time. So now, any action that will start here. You see, this is the action of future continuous tense. The action which will start and continue for some time. See here. Will start and continue for some time. Remember 2 points here. Will start and continue. That's called future continuous tense. Future means will start, continue means continue. So the action which will start in future and continue for some time, go for some time, that's future continuous tense. Action that will start in future and continue for some time. Yes. And tense denoting such action. Tense denoting such work. It's future continuous tense. So, note it down, dear students, the definition, how to define it. Just keep these 2 points. You'll get a complete definition of future continuous tense. The tense which denotes the action that will start in future and continue for some time. Is termed as, known as future continuous tense. Let's see an example. Hari will be reading a book. See. Hari will be reading a book. I mean, this reading will start and continue for some time. Yo bhavishyama suru huncha hunecha ra kehi samay samma chali raheko hunecha. Okay. Let's see the structure. structure here. Subject. Without subject, a sentence can't be formed. So, subject first. Then, shall or will. You can use shall or will. And again, remember, according to the traditional grammar, shall with first and second person, first person, whereas with will is used with second and third person. But now, according to modern grammar, will is used with all. Will is used with all the pronouns. Yes, it's according to modern grammar, AMG. Shall we plus then be and before plus test. Verbs fourth form, ing form is used in continuous tense. So this is the structure. Remember this. Let me give you one more example here. He will be playing tennis. Okay. Now let's come to its real use. Let's come to the real point. That's why we are here. Uses of future continuous tense. Where is future continuous tense used? First, you must know the concept. What is future continuous tense? Then you must know what is its structure. Then you must know how is it used. What are the grounds on which we use? When should we use future continuous tense? कति बेला future continuous tense use गर्ने त कस्तो खालको sentence सँग future continuous tense लाग्छ त? Yes, let's see here. Type, we'll start with examples first. So type one examples. Let's see first. Type one examples. See here. Hari Maya, see dear students, will be reading a story at this time tomorrow. See, my dear students, what is the tense used over here? Will plus be plus before future continuous tense. Why? Because the action will be in progress. The action will be going on tomorrow at this time. This at this time tomorrow denotes that. It says the action will be in progress. The action will go on continuously in the future. That's why future continuous tense is used over here. I mean, future continuous tense is used to the action that will be on the progress in future. Okay? Okay. So let's see. See? Will be to. One at 1 p.m. 1 p.m. the day after tomorrow. See again here. Which tense is used here? Future continuous tense. Why? Because of this. Clock time plus future time verb. We had here at this time plus future time verb. And here we have clock time plus future time verb. It says, denotes that it will be on progress. Sleeping will be on progress. Reading will be on progress here. That's why. See the last example of this. There will be playing tournament at 2 p.m. next Saturday. Next Saturday. See again, what's the tense here? It's future continuous tense. Why? Because of this clock time plus future time. This is, this implies this action will be on progress. So, what is the summary? What is the conclusion here? What I mean to say you by showing these three examples is that future continuous tense is used to the actions which will be on progress, which will be going on continuously for some time in the past, sorry, in the future. So right here, future continuous tense is due to the actions that will be continuously going on for some time in the future. Yes. And this sense of this, the meaning of this can be expressed structurally in this way by writing at this time or clock time plus future time adverbials like tomorrow, the day after tomorrow, next. So with this, at this time or clock time, if these two, any of them, is followed by future time verb, then we use future continuous tense there. So its sense can be expressed in this way structurally. Okay. Now let's talk on to the next type examples of future continuous tense. Okay, let's try two examples. Okay, type two examples, dear students. I'll give you just two examples here. I will be, I want to tell you, will is used with all sorts of pronouns in modern grammar. So, will here. I'll be living in a hotel in Johnson. See, dear students, what is the tense used here? Yup, CT. Future continuous tense. Can you guess why? Guess God? Do you know why? Yes. The reason is, it is a future possible plan. Sambhavit Yojana. A future plan. Right in the bracket. Possible. Yes. Future plan. Future possible plan. So if you have any future possible plan, that plan can be expressed in future continuous tense. It's for you to write. When you write, you can use the structural future continuous tense by denoting your future possible plan. Okay. She will be taking the exam. It's too easy. Yep, CT. And the reason is the same here. Future possible plan here. So, dear students, you too can use future continuous tense while talking about your future possible plan. Okay, so this is the conclusion for you. Future continuous tense is used to the actions, sorry, used with future possible plan. Finished. Okay, now we'll move on to the next future perfect tense. Okay. Future perfect tense. Dear students, see here. Future perfect tense. Okay. Let's see the concept first. Timeline is very important. Present point. Let's say now. It's future time. It's past time. See, what sort of action is denoted by future perfect tense? Future perfect tense denotes such action that will be completed in a future period of time or point of time. Any action that may begin in future or may begin in the future and be completed in the future, or might have begun in the past but will be completed in the future. Hear me say? Future mein shuru bhayera, future mein sakine cha, athwa past ma pani shuru bhayeko huna sakcha, tara sakine feri future mein huncha. So, it will be completed here. But the action, that will be completed in future, either point of time or period of time. Yes, yeah, shuru bhayo char din bhisako sakcha. For example, let me say, let me write definition, then I will give you example first. As a tense which denotes the action that will be completed by future point of time or in a period of time, in a future period of time, in a future period of time is known as future perfect tense. Let's see an example. He will have finished his work by tomorrow. See here. By plus future point of time. I mean, this action will be completed in a future point of time. This is a point of time. Remember this. Point of time. Or C will have come back in 3 days. See this tense. This action, act of coming, will be completed in 3 days. Means in plus future period of time. What are these 3 days? Future period of time. Future period of time. Yes. This is what I mean to say here. The action which will be completed either before a future point of time or in future period of time. Okay, let's come to the structure here, right? Guys, the structure is subject plus shall or will plus have plus V3. Yes. Again, shall with first person, will with second person and third person, but in generally, will is used mostly here. Okay. So, examples are this. Now, let's talk about uses of this. Uses of future perfect tense. See. Hira will have solved the questions by tomorrow. See here again. What is the tense here? future perfect tense.
Why? Because of this by plus future point of time.
It denotes its action will be solved, action will be completed. यसले के देखाउँछ भने भोलिसम्ममा त्यो काम सकिसकेको हुनेछ. दिस इज द मार्कर, दिस इज भेरी इम्पोर्टेन्ट. बाई प्लस फ्युचर पोइन्ट अफ टाइम डिनोट्स द एक्सन विल बी कम्प्लिटेड. द्याट इज वाइ वी हेभ फ्युचर परफेक्ट टेन्स. लेट्स सी फर एक्जाम्पल. Sabina will have reached before her brother arrives. Again, before her brother arrives, it shows before plus future point of time. Before this time, his action will be completed. That's why future perfect tense is here. Let's see one more example. Medical science will have got the vaccine of COVID-19 by the end of 2020. See here. So by plus future point of time is here. By plus future point of time is here. That's why we have future perfect tense here. By the way, dear students, you come. The act of getting the vaccine began in the past. You past me shuru bhayeko cha. Aile pani chalirakheko cha. Tara bhavishyama gera sakine cha. That's why I told you here. This in future perfect tense, action might have started in the past too, but will be completed in future. Okay. So with these all examples, past proof down. Structure is more important here. So right here, by plus future point of time, before plus future point of time, in or within plus future period of time. Yes, dear students, with these structures, future perfect tense is to be used because they denote the action will be completed either in a period of time or by a point of time in the future. So that's all. Thanks so much for watching this virtual class of Finnish grammar.